Hello everyone, welcome to another video from CLLST. This is another video in the series of important legal events of 2019, and today we'll be discussing about the RTI amendment. Now, for any vibrant democracy to function, there should be a proper doctrine of checks and balance. And this doctrine of checks and balance was applied through the Right to Information Act 2005. It is still considered as one of the most successful laws of the democratic India to keep a check on the government, for the citizens to know what the government is doing, and to get any document that the citizens might require information on. Now, coming to the changes that has been brought in by the government under the RTI Act. The changes that has been brought is basically under Section 13 and Section 16 of the Act. Section 13 of the Act originally dealt with the terms of service, the salaries and the tenure of the Central Chief Information Commissioner and the Information Commissioners. Earlier, the tenure of service of the Central Chief Information Commissioner was supposed to be at 5 years or until the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. Now, the change that has been brought under Section 13 for the tenure of service is that it will be decided by the central government. That is, that it would be for such period as the central government may prescribe. Now, coming to the terms of service and the salaries. The terms of service and the salaries of these information commissioners and the chief information commissioners was to be at par with that of chief election commissioner and the election commissioners. Now, the central government has prescribed that this terms of service and this salaries shall be prescribed by the central government. So again, everything related to the services, to the tenure of service, to the salaries, to the terms of service of every chief information commissioner and information commissioners shall be decided by central government. Now, coming to Section 16. Section 16 originally dealt with the state level chief information commissioners and information commissioners. Then again, the change that has been brought in is the same as that of Section 13, that is the terms of service, the tenure of service and the salaries of these chief information commissioners and the information commissioners shall be prescribed by the central government. Earlier, it was supposed to be in concurrence with that of election commissioners, but now it will be decided by the central government. Now, coming to the fact that why this amendment is facing a lot of flak from the opposition as well as from the general public, the main idea behind this is because of this amendment, the independence of the information commissioners and of the chief information commissioners will be hampered. This entire endeavor seems to be just to bring the chief information commissioners and the information commissioners under the absolute control of the government, and that is where it is wrong, because the entire motive behind the bringing the Right to Information Act was to create a system of checks and balance, and also to create good governments and to create transparency. And this transparency won't be there because chief information commissioners and information commissioners now could be biased, could be more loyal towards the central government than the general public to whom they are providing this information. If your entire salary, if your entire tenure, if your entire terms of service is being decided by the central government, then obviously your loyalty will lie more towards your central government than your general public. Also, this entire law was brought in without any public consultation, and that is again against the entire idea behind bringing any legislation, because if you're changing a law like Right to Information, public consultation should have been there, but there was no public consultation. Now, coming to the fact that what is the justification that has been given by the government from bringing these amendment was basically the first reason that the government gave for this amendment was that the salaries and the terms of service of that of election commissioners and that of chief election commissioners was basically under Article 324. The entire election commission was a constitutional body that was established under Article 324 of the Constitution, whereas the RTI is a separate act. It is not basically a constitutional mandate, but it is a separate act in itself, and therefore you cannot compare election commissioners and chief election commissioners to information commissioners and chief information commissioners. This was the reason that was given by the government for changing the salary structure, changing the terms of service. In fact, the government even stated that they are just correcting what the earlier governments did wrong. According to them, the RTI 2005 was brought in a bit of a hurry and they are just correcting what should have been there at a very earlier stage. Also, according to the government, the Chief Information Commissioner was given a status as equal to that of a Supreme Court judge. But appeals against him could be decided by a judge of a high court. Therefore, how can this happen if your appeal can lie before a high court judge and your status is that of a Supreme Court judge? That will disturb the hierarchy of the courts, and that is why the government is saying that they are bringing all these changes. Now, this was all about RTI amendment. If you have any doubts, any queries, you can post it in the comments. Thank you. Happy preparing.
Career launcher. Make your parents explode with joy.